the mom and daughter would drift apart. They become not friends. And then come after 25, then they become best friends again.
Yeah. So I completely understand that later on in life. And Kirsten's not going to be there forever.
No.
I mean, it's as simple as that, right? Like, Kirsten has already stated that she wants to break up with Angela on multiple occasions, right? Mm-hmm. To Trinity, my youngest sister, right? She tells her that. Like, yeah, I think I'll probably break up with her eventually, right? And Aunt Trinity is just like, all right. And you go ahead and do your thing, right? And then Angela won't listen to her. So
I don't want to know that. This afternoon, love's not going to last forever. Think of it as temporary. You guys get so young. She's not the only relationship I have, so be prepared for that.
And she doesn't comprehend that.
Yeah.
And you don't necessarily have to comprehend that through pain. You have to you learn that after you develop who you are, right? And you can't do that if you have another person. And sadly, that generally is found out when you go through a breakup. That's why some people turn into, like, you know, like, they're just like, they sleep around in a perfect place, right? Again, not saying that there's anything wrong with that. But that's what they want to do, right? And they find that out because they don't want to be tied down to one single person. Or say they get break up with one person, like, hey, you know, I long a loving relationship, right? So they always want to stay with one person and take the abuse, you know? You find out who you are, sadly, in those moments because those are the defining characteristics that are, like, get exposed because now this other part of you is no longer there. What kind of person are you? If I'm with someone and they want to leave me, I will still know who I am. I will still be like this. Right. And I definitely did not have the self-confidence a year and a half ago when I was with Anna, right? And then I tried to continue to carry this when I was with her. She even said, you want too many serious things? I don't know if I'm ready for that. I know I can carry on a mediocre relationship. And I was like, so be it.
But hey, how come you were so adamant about your mom's closer singing and just no longer?
Because of her. It was that. It was a way for me to escape. It's what I wanted to do. I still do want to do that. I very much am still getting very patriotic. Whole bunch of military stuff. I definitely am focused on learning on stuff like that all the time. However, the reason behind why I was doing it in that moment was wrong. Right?
Wrong?
Yeah. Whereas opposed to if I had done it now, and then her and I had gone back together, I would still do it. I left because I thought that her and I would never... But I know that subconsciously somewhere I probably stopped because I thought her and I would have had a chance. But when her and I broke up, and I left the military, and then I was like, hey, I left the military. And she was like, oh, well, we're still going to stay broken up. And I was like, that wasn't what I was expecting. So that's also when I realized that subconsciously a part of me did want that. Even though I will still think that forwardly I don't, yeah, I probably did. You know, I trust my subconscious a lot. Like, if I'm going, hey, you know what, I probably did that, I most likely did it. And that's what will be my answer. You know, because experience like that was like, hey, you know what's going on, right? Even though you don't want to acknowledge it or push it down, you know what's going on, right? And so that's where I'm like, I left because I thought I could have a life different in that moment, where if I had done that, I would have had a different life. Not saying one that wouldn't have been great or one that I wouldn't have enjoyed. It was one that I thought I could want. Whereas now, I could do that. However, the way my life is going is down the direction that fully utilize more. You know, I probably still would have been on the same path if I had done that. Now I just get it a lot sooner, I would say personally. And actually, I'm a little bit thankful for leaving because I wouldn't have found my team if I hadn't. I wouldn't have been a part of the business or the organization I have. I probably would have been a lot leaner. Because, like, you know, most people jump from a ditch to ditch. You know, so if you go from a loser and then you're an absolute winner, then you hate everyone who's in that other ditch, right? But again, that's not right either. You know, whereas now I feel like I'm more straight arrow, maybe closer to the other ditch though. Right, but now I'm rising above it, you know.
So with Chase, you still have a way to leverage or parlay education through them, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because the military would have helped you out, but you're not in that. But with Chase, good. So you didn't totally miss it, and you had no way of getting the education.
Absolutely. And again, that just depends on the case, education that I'm wanting now. I still haven't quite decided. The thing is that although I'm building a business, people go like, hey, you know, why don't you take business classes, right? Why would I take business classes from someone who doesn't own a business?
Right.
Doesn't make sense to me, right?
Yeah. Those who can't do teach.
Exactly, right? Exactly, and yeah. That's the wrong thing. It's like, why would you even listen to it? I listen to people with credibility, you know? I won't listen to my parents about some things at all. I won't listen to them generally for some of their marriage advice, some of their financial decisions. Some of their work decisions, you know. It's just you pick and choose. I want to be
zone. Yeah, you're way above the your peer.
Yeah.
Right? Don't you agree?
Yeah.
A lot more.
Yeah, I get like I said, not that I'm back, but I get asked a lot. Like, hey man, like how are you? You look pretty young. 19.
Right.
They're like, oh, I thought you were like 25 or 27.
Yeah, you had to have an education to get that kind of learning.
Yeah, and so like I would listen to them. Right? So I'm not going to go to school for business. I'm not going to school for communications, right? But I'm also, I would say, exceptionally good at that. And my health understanding is one field that I was actually really comfortable with because it's like, hey, you know what? If I'm going to learn about health, I should learn from health professionals.
Mm.
Well, you can't teach something if you're not a health professional, right? Like, you have to know how to, otherwise you can cost someone their life, right? And so I was like, you know what? If I'm going to be studying health, then these people definitely have a background and have some success there. Whereas opposed to, like, if someone's teaching, you know, how do you ride a horse, but they've never been on a horse, it's like, that doesn't make a lot of sense. You know, why would I listen to someone who works out if they're fat? You know?
Right. I told you what I would say. Go find the one who's successful, model after them. That's
exactly.
It.
That's
simple
exactly.
As that, yeah.
And that's one of the things that we teach too. You know, so, I mean, success is duplicated. So is failure, though. But it can be duplicated, right? All you have to do is understand it. Copy them.
Copy.
Style them after your living self. Like, give it a little personal flair, right? And that's what I try and do personally, you know? And, but that's the thing, is that it can be duplicated. You know, like that. Warren Buffett bought Coca-Cola, I think, in 2013, right? And then he upped the price of the Coca-Cola by 1 cent. And then people are like, why would you buy it without someone? And I said, because of 1 cent, they already have success. All I have to do is now turn a profit. And I can do that with my own business. He also reads the 1953 Ford Automotive Magazine, at least once a year, like their playbook on how they've been so successful in the 1950s. And people are like, why are you reading the old manual, right? And he goes, because success is timeless, right?
Except when you include, yeah.
Exactly. You can model it after anything. Have to change what the model is, you know? And that's for someone who definitely has success, right? So it makes sense.
That's why people are still reading The Art of War from 2,000 years ago. Because the strategy worked. It still worked.
Exactly.